If you track with the channel, you'll recognise our look at PlayStation 4 co-op games for families, from Little Big Planet, Rocket League. We've got some stickball going on. We took these to real families and tested them out. We also looked at Towerfall, Ascension, and of course Tricky Towers. And finally, we looked at Rayman Legends. But we're going to look at some new upcoming or just out games for families. And we're going to start today by looking at LEGO Worlds. Now, this is a little bit different from the traditional LEGO games we're used to in video game format on PlayStation 4. Rather than following the plot of a particular movie, whether that's Lord of the Rings or Star Wars or Indiana Jones or any of those LEGO games that we've enjoyed in our household, LEGO Worlds is a much more open adventure. So this is a little bit like Minecraft meets the LEGO games. You can explore, you can discover, you can create, and on PlayStation you can do that together. Now, we've played this before on our PC, and you could get into those games, you could create and you could craft, but you had to only do it with one player because each player needed their own computer. On PlayStation, you can go into a split screen mode, and as you can see here, this has been the moment that my boys have really jumped onto this from other games like Terraria and Minecraft. In the game, you explore a whole variety of different worlds, and as you do that, you uncover hidden treasures as well as environments. Now, these can range from sort of fun and fantastical to science fiction to snow monsters to cavemen to explorers. All those classic LEGO characters are recreated in the game, and as you adventure, you unlock more builds and more parts, and so you can slowly do more and more in the game. The other benefit that I really like about having this on the PlayStation in our living room is that everyone else in the room gets involved in what's happening on the screen, takes an interest, and often takes part too. And the kids have really enjoyed, as you can see here, showing their grandparents how to play, and not only showing them how to play, but getting them involved as well. And I think there's a real healthy benefit in here, with kids, parents, and grandparents enjoying a game together, but also learning and playing together, much like that kind of traditional LEGO experience. And certainly, their grandparents and them seem to have got a lot more out of the game, have just discovered new ways to play it, have created things together, have done collaborative builds in that LEGO Worlds environment that has been really a positive part of our play downstairs in the living room. As you can see here, as Granny takes to the controls, the boys really enjoy pointing out where she should go, how she can find items, the things that they've discovered in the game while they've been playing it. And because the controls are relatively simple, you've just got a couple of sticks there and some basic buttons to do the different building. You can soon pick it up, and you can see Granny is on an elephant and exploring the world with her grandsons. And equally, because it's cooperative, it means the boys can jump in and help her if she gets stuck. So that's a really nice game, I think, that's just out on PlayStation 4, has that co-op experience and a whole open world of LEGO fun to explore and enjoy together. So as we lead them to explore their LEGO Safari, we're going to look at another new game upcoming on PlayStation 4, and that is Yooka-Laylee. Now, those who are longer in the tooth in gaming times may recognise some of the developers here, because it is the talent behind Banjo-Kazooie and Donkey Kong Country games. Now, these are the kind of open world exploration games, a little bit like Mario 64. So Yooka-Laylee has that same exploration of huge worlds. It's got some beautiful environments, has a whole wide cast of characters that you slowly unlock as you work your way through it. And what I like here is it's a real re-emergence of a type of game that we haven't seen very much before. We've had platform games recently, but not in that kind of open world exploration. So each of the environments, as you can see, we're playing through here, kind of a jungle level, but each of them slowly opens up with more and more layers. So as you play through, you meet characters and they unlock certain tasks. And as you complete those tasks and collect the in-game currency, which is quills and pages of books, you can unlock more of the game and more of the challenge. The game scales to the ability of your child, and it goes up in difficulty as they get better at it. Even the levels themselves are expanded as you play through the game and you perform better and better. Now, what the family has enjoyed about Yooka-Laylee, along with those nice characters environments, is that we really had to work together to figure out how to progress through each of the levels. There's a real sense of identifying what the next challenge is, where you need to go, And as you interact with it and as you progress, slowly, slowly, you get a sense of everything you can collect in that particular environment before you move on to the next level. As well as the single player mode, as you can see here, you can also jump in with a second controller, controlling a second character in a co-op mode. And that second character is great because they can come along and they can zap and stun enemies to help that main character through. And that works both ways. It can work with a parent playing on the main game and the child protecting them by zapping those enemies. Equally, as a dad or a mum or a grandparent, you can come in and you can help a younger player progress through the game by protecting them with that second character too. You see the boys here swapping over and taking turns to progress through this main adventure. Some of the platforming does take a bit of challenge, and there's some real moments where you have to jump absolutely right, but that is kind of all part of the fun. As we're going to see, they're just trying to make this final jump. Are they going to make it?
Yes,
nice. So there you go, they're going to progress through to the next challenge in this part of the world. And we're going to look ahead at some PlayStation 4 family games that are coming up over the next few months, the first of which is Snake Pass. Now this is really fascinating. To look at it, it doesn't look that complicated or unusual, but it's the controls here that make this absolutely stand out. The way the snake moves there uses something called real-time physics. So you have to work with the objects in the world, you have to work with the geometry, the weight, and the maneuverability of your body to work your way through these different mazes. So it's a real test of challenge, test of fun, test of your reflexes, as well as working out how to solve these puzzles. But equally, it's a really strong Snake character. So I think for families, Snake Pass is a game you absolutely have to check out. And this brings us on to a game that I used to play when I was younger, which is Micro Machines back on the PlayStation 1. This is coming out this year for PlayStation 4, and as you can see, in highly upscaled, detailed visuals and audio. Now, the novelty here is that you're racing tiny little character cars through everyday scenarios. So you've got a pool table here, you have missiles, you have various weapons, and you could upgrade your cars as they go. But the novelty is just racing around everyday environments, whether that's the breakfast table, whether that is this pool table, or anywhere else, maybe out in the garden. Now, keeping with the racing theme, but going in a very different direction, is Wipeout. Wipeout Amiga Collection, coming to the PlayStation 4. Now, this is a collection of the previous Wipeout games with some upgrades and some new visuals and sound. Now, families could easily, I think, disregard this if you've got younger children, but actually, I found in my home that the automatic steering, the tilt steering of the controller, along with an auto steer that keeps you roughly on track, has actually made this one of the most accessible racing games. And of course, the space, the high octane racing, and those missiles make it great fun for kids of all ages too. So do check out Wipeout Amiga Collection, coming on PlayStation 4 this year. Then back in retro territory, we have Crash Bandicoot Sane Trilogy on the PlayStation 4. And as you can see, this is Crash Bandicoot reimagined for a new generation. So it's kind of a platform puzzle game, action, bit of strategy involved as well. You have to work your way down this kind of laned challenges, avoiding the enemies, collecting the boxes, and it gets more and more frantic. Anyone who remembers the original Crash games back on the PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2 will know exactly what to do here. And again, I think for families, this is a game you're going to be playing together, challenging each other to see who can complete these levels the quickest and who can get the furthest. Certainly in my home, we're going to be looking forward to revisiting Crash again, because I remember playing Crash back on the PlayStation 1 when I was a child, and I'm wanting to introduce my kids to it too. Then finally, for our look at PlayStation 4 family games this year, let's finish with some Lego. Having started with Lego World, this is Lego City Undercover. So it still has that same open world feel as Lego Worlds, but this is a very much more detailed, hand-built environment where you have to discover a whole storyline unfolding in this city. You meet loads of characters, you get loads of upgrades, and there's a real sense of exploration and adventure. This is a game which we saw previously on the Wii U, but here on PlayStation 4, a significant enhancement, not only visually, but also the fact that you can now play co-op. And for my family, that is a massive benefit, because we want to play these Lego games together. It's fine to play taking turns on some of these games, but if you can both get in and play at the same time, like you can in Lego Worlds, then there's a lot more value here. So, Lego City Undercover, coming this year on PlayStation 4, is another game to really watch out for. So I hope that's been helpful. Do let us know in the comments which PlayStation 4 games are working best for your family. Which PlayStation 4 games are you looking out for the most? Are you looking for Lego Worlds? Are you looking forward to Crash Bandicoot? Are you looking forward to Wipeout? Are you looking forward to Snake Pass? Are you looking forward to Micro Machines? Or are you enjoying Yooka-Laylee? So let us know how you get on, and we'll be in the comments just as soon as this video goes live.